Studying for the MCAT while working a full-time job can seem like a difficult challenge. However, many students with full-time jobs or full-time class schedules manage to achieve a high score and succeed on the MCAT. Welcome back to the Shemmassian Academic Consulting YouTube channel. My name is Vikram Shaw, and today we'll be discussing four important tips to keep in mind if you're planning on studying for the MCAT while also working at a full-time job. To build a successful study schedule, there are a few key considerations we want to keep in mind. These points will also apply to students who are studying for the MCAT without working a full-time job. However, we've adapted the specific timelines for those who are working a full-time job while studying for the MCAT. One reason that studying for the MCAT while working a full-time job might seem daunting is the sheer amount of time it takes to read and learn all of the content that can be presented. While you may not have the luxury of dedicating 8 to 10 hours a day to studying for the MCAT, you can still fit your studying in with smaller chunks of time. Over the next few minutes, we'll discuss strategies you can use to maximize your efficiency while still maintaining your work quality. While it's by no means an easy task, the skills you will develop now will serve you well throughout medical school and the rest of your life. Tip number one, complete smaller tasks throughout the day. Many times when students sit down to study, they have the mindset that they need to study for several hours without getting distracted at all, and really just be perfect over the course of those several hours while they're studying. While it's true that studying uninterrupted for a few hours can help you score well on the MCAT, it's not absolutely necessary. Performing small tasks throughout the day can also be extremely valuable study time, despite what you may think. For instance, covering 1 or 2 hours of content every night may allow you to take the MCAT in much less than a year. When planning your study schedule, it's important not to let perfect be the enemy of good. For instance, while taking a full-length practice psychology and sociology section might be ideal, doing 5 or 10 problems at a time is much better than doing nothing at all. Again, don't let perfect be the enemy of good. Completing small tasks consistently will help move the needle in the right direction over time, even though you might not be conventionally studying for the MCAT by putting in many hours a day. Other small tasks may be built into your daily living routine, such as using flashcards to review and memorize vocabulary on your daily commute, or doing a practice cars passage as soon as you wake up in the morning. The key to making this approach to studying work is being able to build consistency in your schedule. Studying for an hour or two every day for a few months will indeed begin to add up. However, studying an hour or two sporadically for a few months will lead to little or really no progress at all. Another great mentality to keep is that action leads to motivation. Many of us, myself included, often think that the more motivated we are to do something, the more likely we are to do it. However, motivation fades quickly. A more sustainable approach is to base your studying around action instead of motivation. Action leads to motivation, which in turn leads to even more motivation. As you see yourself make incremental progress as a result of your action, you're more motivated to keep on working and keep on studying. So, long story short, if you keep on completing that practice cars passage every morning, you're more likely to sustain your studying and motivation for a longer period of time. Tip number two, take plenty of practice full-length exams. In addition to studying consistently for small periods of time to cover your content knowledge and start making a dent in your practice problems, sitting down to regularly take full-length exams is incredibly important. Taking these practice exams will allow you to synthesize the content knowledge you've reviewed, assess your progress at points in time, and develop the stamina to take an 8-hour exam. When planning your study schedule, be sure to plan to take at least 5 full-length exams, one at the beginning of your studying, and at least 4 in the weeks leading up to your exam. These may be best scheduled during weekends, holidays, or strategically scheduled vacation days. As someone studying for the MCAT with a full-time job, this phase of your preparation will undoubtedly be the most difficult. You'll find it challenging to take a full-length exam after working a full week at your job. With that being said, there are some ways to work around this. For example, if you know that you'll take a full-length exam on Saturday, be sure to get plenty of rest when your work week finishes on Friday. You can even pretend that you're going in for another day at work on Saturday. If fitting in a full-length exam is impossible, given your full-time job and life responsibilities, try breaking up your full-length exams into bite-sized pieces. For example, you can take your chem phys section after work on Monday, your cars section after work on Tuesday, your biology and biochemistry section after work on Wednesday, and your psych section after work on Thursday. Then take Friday completely off from your MCAT work and review your exam on Saturday and or Sunday. With the proper foresight and planning, it's possible to fit in a substantial number of full-length MCAT practice tests even while you're working a full-time job. Tip number 3, plan for contingencies. Despite all your best planning, emergencies and unexpected situations may arise. When planning your study schedule and signing up for a test date, don't forget to consider personal and professional obligations in your life that might end up consuming more time than you initially expected. These might include pressing work deadlines, family holidays and gatherings, or even sick days. Building an extra few weeks or even a month into your study schedule may allow you to catch up on any material you may be behind on at a much less frantic pace, while still being able to indulge in the enjoyable aspects of your non-MCAT life. There are two general approaches to building flexibility into your study schedule. The first approach is a weekly flex day. The main goal of this day is to rest and recharge, so ideally you won't schedule any MCAT work on this day. We want you to approach that next week reset and ready to attack your MCAT goals for that week. With that being said, if you get behind during the week, you can use this day as a time to catch up. The second approach, which is similar to what we mentioned before, is to include an extra week, up to an extra month, of extra time in your study prep to account for unexpected life events that may periodically interfere with your studying. So, if a major life event comes up that causes you to miss an entire week of studying, it's not a problem, as that simply eats into that flex time you've built at the end of your study schedule before your test day. Tip number 4, build a support community. Finally, to our fourth tip on studying for the MCAT while working a full-time job. Any difficult task is always easier when you have a supportive community by your side. Studying for the MCAT is no exception. During this time, it can be incredibly important to have a group of trusted friends and family you can rely on for support. These members of your support community don't necessarily need to also be studying for the MCAT, but they can still be your biggest cheerleaders. You may ask them to do things such as run small errands and chores for you, spend time with you as you're studying, or even check in with you in your study schedule every day to make sure you're being held accountable. Studying for the MCAT while working a full-time job is difficult, but it's far from impossible. Throughout this video, we've gone over a few tips for building a successful study schedule if you're working full-time while studying for the MCAT. We really hope this video has been a helpful resource for you in your MCAT studying. If you'd like an MCAT question of the day delivered to your inbox every single day, click the link in our description below. In addition, feel free to leave a comment if there's an MCAT topic you'd like to see us cover. Finally, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and like this video if you'd like to see more videos like this. We'll see you next time, and best of luck studying.